All right, good morning, Canada. Good morning, AM. Good morning,
Kels. We're ready to go, Brandon.
We are so ready to go because we're talking about a hot button topic, right? It's something that resonates with so many people, and it's a big issue leading up to the provincial election here in Ontario. But today in our Your Take Chat, we're taking a look, rather, at childcare costs right across this country, and it is something that affects families across Canada, right? Mm-hmm. I would love to hear about your guys' experience because AM, for example, you had three kids all at once.
Yes, so we priced it out, we cost it out. It was cheaper for us rather than put three kids in childcare to bring somebody in. Now that's an option for us. Both my husband and I work full time. It is not an option for everybody. And in fact, sometimes childcare, Kelsey, you know, this can be so expensive. Mm-hmm. You know, one of the partners says, is it worth it for me to go back to work? Because all of my salary for the first mm-hmm. 5 years until they hit school is going to be taken up with childcare.
Kelsey, you lived in Alberta before.
Yeah.
Now you live in Ontario. Have you seen a difference?
Well, so we, in Calgary, we found the childcare costs to be extremely high, and we were fortunate to live outside of the city. We lived a little bit north in a community called Airdrie, where it was a little bit less expensive for us. But still, it took up, it was basically one mortgage payment went to our childcare. So for me, when I went back to work, that was a large part of my salary. Coming here, I mean, we obviously work so early, so does my husband, and we both have to commute into the city because we couldn't afford to live in the city.
Right.
So your budget, it's factored in so many different ways. Anyway, we brought someone in as well for us, which worked now. But Ontario, the biggest difference we found is the fact that school starts earlier here because there's 2 years of kindergarten. Yeah. It's at least 1 year less of childcare. Mm-hmm. But I mean, when you're paying till they're five, it can impact
it's
the number of kids you have.
Yeah, it really is. So what we did a bit of research and a bit of digging to find out what is the average cost of childcare in cities across this country. And you'll find out it's pretty striking. It is expensive for many cities. So take a look here. In Toronto, you know, we are topping over $1,400. And this is per month.
Is that per kid?
Per kid, exactly.
Wow.
Vancouver, nearly as expensive, hitting close to $1,200. Ottawa, just over $1,000. But take a look, though, at Montreal. How affordable it is compared to all the other cities. And it, because it's what we're seeing that, and you probably heard about the Quebec model, is where there's a set fee, and it's a really reasonable price, that parents pay per child per day. But how does this all unfold? What is the Quebec model? If you don't know about it, well, let's take a look into it. Basically, childcare costs, they're set by the government and they're implemented on a sliding scale based on family income. So, for example, if you make a certain amount in Quebec, if your family income is just under $52,000, then childcare costs just under $8 a day. Now, if your family makes up, you know, in excess of $160,000, then you pay about $21 a day. But how do they get this cost so low for families?
Taxes.
The thing is that taxes. So taxes are higher in Quebec than almost every other province in this country. But the province also invests more in childcare. So they spend per year over $2 billion alone in childcare costs. Like, just out of provincial coffers. Mm-hmm. What does that translate, though? It translates into cheaper fees for parents at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. The drawback, though, that we found is that because it's so affordable, more parents want to put their children into childcare, so we're seeing longer wait lists in some cities in Quebec. And what they do is that they kind of have this mix of system where there are centers that are operated by the province that offer these great services for your children. So there's a long wait list to get into those services rather than the regulated childcare spaces that are operated by your next door neighbor,
even,
for example.
Yeah, but even with that subsidy, you can still afford to do one or the other.
Exactly.
Whereas in Ontario, it is cost prohibitive for a lot of people.
And in BC, in so many provinces. So we know that, you know, this has been a hot button issue for many governments, many levels of governments, including municipal, provincial, and federal. So the federal government has allocated over $7 billion that they want to disperse across the country to help build more childcare spaces, because one of the other issues were the long wait lists that we're experiencing in many different places. But we're also noticing that there has been a commitment by many provincial governments, for example, in Ontario, to build in excess of 100,000 new spaces. And the government is doing that. We will give them credit. We have noticed that Ontario is leading the pack in this country with building the most spaces over the last 2 years.
You could argue they also have the most need.
Exactly. Because there's been a lack of that infrastructure for these children. So there's a drought. So they have to fill that.
Yes.
And so it is taking time to do that. But still, it is still expensive.
Yeah.
And that's the thing.
some daycare options, we should mention those totals that we saw on the screen, some do offer the option when you have a second child or third child. You're paying a little bit less mm-hmm. for those second and third child because you already have one registered.
Right.
But still, the first thing you Google when it says how many kids do Canadians have, the first news articles say it's the cost of kids that stop you from having more.
And it stops people from going back to work.
Yeah.
This is what the scientific research has shown, is that when you are paying so much for childcare, and it usually falls on the woman, unfortunately, the mother, where it prohibits them from going back to work because they end up staying at home. So this is the question for you, Canada. Here's your hashtag, your take question. And yes, you must use that hashtag. Childcare costs, how do they affect you? We want you to chime in on this conversation. Let us know your personal experience with this on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. It's a great conversation. More news and weather coming up right after this break.